God's door. He restored my soul. When you become a believer, your spirit is made right. Sometimes the soul doesn't get the notice. It has a hold in it due to things that's happened in the past, hurt, abuse, molestation. But we want to speak to you today and tell you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. Some people's actions are not because their spirit is wrong, but it's because the past has left a hole in their soul. May this wisdom help you get over your past and remind you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. I have my sister Leandria here. She's going to help me share this wisdom and tell this story.
Thank you. Good morning, family. I speak blessings over you today. Amen. I know this is something new. I did not post this on Facebook yet. But today is the beginning of day one of prayer and fasting. I have been assigned prayer and fasting weeks. Originally, this week was supposed to be the only week of prayer and fasting for me. But my leader told me that I could, you know, add more days. So I said, well, might as well just go ahead and add another week. I am believing God that I will hear from Him, from heaven. Either, you know, God will speak to me directly, or He will speak through the woman of God, or, you know, through one of my friends who's also decided to join the fast with me, also. Amen. But whomever He speaks to will receive the word and go forth and walk it out. But, I'm believing and having faith that I will receive a word by this Saturday and another word by next Saturday. Amen. Intercession, you have to have faith to know that God is going to speak. You have to have faith to know that your prayers are effective and they're reaching heaven. Amen. So we want to start off day one with prayer and fasting. I want to start off with a devotion. Amen. I want to thank God for using Donald Lawrence, Tri-City Seniors, and Leandria Johnson to remind us to deliver us. And that's one of the prayers that we're going to be praying about today, is for deliverance, because we need it. Amen and amen. But today I want us to go to a devotion, and we're going to be basically reading. I have a book that my friend's mother gave me. It's a devotional book. She gave me this for my birthday. This book is awesome, and it is. But let's read devotion. This is day 6, July 6th. So we're going to read devotion 6 for the month of July. And it basically says, speak with them in such a way they will want to listen to you. Do not let your talk sound foolish. Keyword is foolish. Don't let what you're saying sound foolish. And that's basically, you know, when it comes down to speaking about God and His kingdom and what the Word of God says. A word spoken at the right time is like fruit of gold set in silver. A wise man speaking strong words to a listening ear is like a piece of gold for the ear and a beautiful object of the fine gold. Watch your talk. No bad words should be coming from your mouth. Say what is good. Your words should help others grow as Christians. A good man will speak good things because of the good in him. A bad man will speak bad things because of the sin in him. That's important. It is by your words that you will not be guilty. The tongue of the wise brings healing. Basically mean. And let me tell you what that first paragraph means is, when you are a child of God, no negative words, including profanity or gossip or damnation, should be coming out of your mouth. Only healing, words of, you know, praises to God, things like that. Only good things should be coming out of your mouth. Don't even let people take you to that place where, you know, negative things will begin to come out of your mouth. Because when you're a child of God, you have to understand you are operating in the supernatural, not in the natural world. And you have to understand the Bible tells us that we wrestle against flesh and blood. I mean, not against flesh and blood, excuse me, but against principalities and powers of dark places. So basically means you have to understand, you have to know what you're wrestling with. When a person comes to you, talk to you in a crazy way, you have to discern, God, are they wrestling with, am I wrestling with flesh and blood, or am I wrestling with principalities and powers and darkness? And majority of the time, you're wrestling with principalities, darkness, and powers. So you have to know how to come to it. And normally when, if the enemy try to present something to you that is sin, but he tries to disguise it to make it seem like it's good, and he's using a demon to do that, you have to go at that demon that's inside of that person and confront it. Not confront the person, but confront the demon and cast it out and rebuke it. That's basically what that means. So when you're a Christian, make sure that there's nothing but good things coming out of your mouth. Healing, prosperity, blessings, you know, I'm letting people know of God's miracles, signs, and wonders. That kind of stuff. Nothing negative should be coming out of your mouth. But I hadn't done this in a long time because back then I used to cuss a lot, but still would tell people about God's word. You cannot cuss and at the same time minister God's words, and don't cuss and minister God's word in the same sentence, because no one is going to receive that. So we have to be mindful of what we say. You know, cussing it out, fussing it out, and fighting it out is not always the answers to everything. So that's basically what that paragraph is saying. You have to be mindful of what you're saying, because you're a child of God. You just can't be saying any kind of thing, because no one gets the pass. So, and as we go on, it says, those who feared the Lord spoke often to one another, and the Lord listened to them. And the names of those who worshiped the Lord were honored and honored him were written down before him in a book to be remembered. If you take out what is of worth from what is of no worth, then you will speak for me. You are rich in everything. You have faith. You can preach. You have much learning. You have a strong desire to help. Now to do what should about giving also. That's a powerful devotion. Like I said, the first paragraph basically means that when you are a child of God, nothing negative is coming out your mouth. Only positive is coming out your mouth. That means no profanity, no damning people, no saying that people are going to go to hell or any of that stuff. Nothing negative, no gossip, nothing will come out of your mouth. Even when, sometimes God uses people to test you. But whenever a person comes to you with a perverted mindset or presenting something to you that is sin, and you know it's sin, the first thing to do is not to cuss them out, not to go off on them, but the first thing is to do is speak well, speak loving, speak kindness. Also know whether you're dealing with flesh or blood, or if you're speaking to principalities, demons, legions, whatever, so you'll know what to do. So you can cast down that. So know that, and then the next thing is, of course, you know, if you're a child of God, you're fearfully and wonderfully made in Him, go tell somebody about God. Let them know about God. Hey, Jesus is great. Jesus is awesome. Jesus is coming back soon. Let them know about God. Let them know about God. Let them know who He is. Don't be afraid to let people know who God is, because that's going to be many people that's going to reject the love of God. They're going to reject God, and they're going to reject the things that God that God has done for them. And to be honest, I don't really feel like it's their fault, because it's how they were taught young. But still, they're going to reject God. Don't let that get you upset. Don't let that get you mad. Don't let that get you going off. Just say that God loves you. He wants to use you. And I'm going to pray for you. Amen and amen. And of course, the scriptures that's coming with though with this whole thing, this whole devotion is powerful. But Colossians 4 and 6, Proverbs 25 and 11 and 12, Ephesians 4, 29, Matthews 12, 35, Matthews 12, 37, Proverbs 12, 18, Malachi 3, 16, Jeremiah 15, 19, and 2 Corinthians 8 and 7. Amen. And amen. And amen. I'm going to make sure I underline all of that because that's very important. Amen. So let's go ahead and let's see God's face and let's pray. If you know how to pray in your heavenly language, please pray that. You know, if you don't know how to pray in heavenly language, just, you know, say Jesus. And also, God is filling. So if you want God to fill you with the Holy Ghost so that you can be able to speak in your heavenly language, ask God for that language and God will give it to you. Because, I mean, not everybody knows how to speak in their heavenly language, which is the spirit of speaking in tongues. But if you ask God, I believe that God will give it to you because God did it for me. I asked God for the gift of speaking in tongues and God blessed me with that gift. And I thank God for that gift. And that gift is a weapon. It's a powerful weapon. And, you know, it edifies you as the Bible says. And the enemy does not know what you're saying when you're speaking in tongues. And the best thing about it is when you're speaking in tongues, you're automatically being broadcast to the Father and He is understanding everything that you are saying. Amen. So let's go ahead and pray. Oh Father God, we thank you. God, we love you. God, we praise you. Lord God, we honor you. We adore you today, God. Lord God, we declare, Lord God, that there is no other God besides you, beneath you, and above you, Lord God. You're the only true and living God. And for that, Lord God, we give you praise, we bless you, we glorify you, we honor you, Lord God. And we give you all the glory, Lord God, that is due your name, Lord God. Lord God, today we pray, Lord God, that you will deliver us, Lord God, from anything that is not like you, Lord God. First, God, we repent, Lord God, we ask that you will forgive us for every unrighteous way, every unrighteous sin, anything that we have done unrighteously and unholy. Lord God, we ask that you will forgive us, Lord God, for our sins, our transgressions, and our iniquity, Lord God. That you will, Lord God, forgive us, Lord God, wipe our slate clean as snow, Lord God. And Lord God, that you will deliver us, Lord God, from anything that is not like you, Lord God. Lord God, the enemy may make us think that it's okay, that this and that and that and this, Lord God. But Lord God, you still love us, Lord God. You still love the sinner. There's someone that the enemy has lied to that said that God doesn't love you, that you are a sinner, that's what you're going to be, and that you belong but in hell. But I cast that thought down and that imagination down. God loves you. God loves sinners. God just doesn't love the sin that you're committing. So God, I just pray that you will forgive each and every sinner for every addiction, for every sin that they continue to run to when they are going through something, Lord God. And my prayer today is that you will, Lord God, allow them to seek you, that you will make them whole, happy, joyful, Lord God, that they will receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit and fire, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Because you said after the Holy Ghost has fell upon you, you shall receive fire of the Holy Ghost, Lord God. Give them fire now, Lord God, and that when the fire comes to them, Lord God, that they will receive cleansing, Lord God. And Lord God, every demonic spirit, everything that is not like you has fallen by the power of God, Lord God. But Lord God, we ask that you would deliver us, Lord God, from perversion. Deliver us, Lord God, from, Lord God, lust, sexual desires, desires of money, Lord God, and fame. Deliver us, Lord God, from a carnal mindset, Lord God. Deliver us, Lord God, from, Lord God, a lying tongue, Lord God, false witnessing, Lord God. Lord God, deliver, Lord God, the church, Lord God, from perversion that's going on in the church, Lord God. Deliver us, Lord God, from lesbianism and homosexuality, Lord God, and prostitution, Lord God. Anything, Lord God, those are the sum of the sins, Lord God. Adultery, Lord God. Fornication, Lord God. Any sin that is against you, Lord God, even the ones that you hate, that are in danger, Lord God. Envy, greed, jealousy, Lord God. Anything, Lord God, please forgive us now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Lord God, we declare, Lord God, that we want more of you, Lord God. So, Lord God, we ask you today that you will fill us, Lord God, with your glory. Fill us, Lord God, with more of you, Lord God. Fill us again, Lord God, with the Holy Spirit, Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Lord God. We need you, Lord God. We want you. We crave for you. We thirst for you, Lord God. And Lord God, we thirst for righteousness. We thirst for, Lord God, holiness, Lord God. Keep us holy before you, Lord God. Now, even when we, Lord God, have to deal with tests, Lord God, and trials and tribulations, Lord God, to know that we can trust and that we're strong in you, Lord God. Like the man of God said on Sunday, Lord God, our afflictions blesses us, Lord God, and we are made to be a blessing towards others, Lord God. It makes us stronger, Lord God, when we are afflicted, Lord God. But, Lord God, we pray, Lord God, that you, Lord God, will bless us, Lord God, to be a blessing to someone else, Lord God. Then when we see someone less fortunate while we're walking on the streets or while we're in our cars, we will bless them, but that we will have discernment to know that they are going to do what they said that they needed, that money or anything, Lord God, to do, Lord God. Lord God, allow us not to be selfish, Lord God, but allow us, Lord God, to be a blessing to someone else. Yes, God, we may have it all, Lord God, but allow us to bless that other person, Lord God. Not just bless our family members and our sons and daughters, but bless people that are walking across the street, Lord God, that are homeless and are less fortunate, Lord God. Be a blessing to them, Lord God. But that's what you wanted us to do, Lord God, to be a blessing towards them, Lord God. And not only them, but the ones that are in the hospital, in the jail cells, Lord God. Those, Lord God, that need something to drink and something to eat and clothing, Lord God. Allow us to bless them, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Oh, God, we need you, Lord God. Oh, God, we want you, Lord God. And we want you to get the glory, Lord God, and get the honor out of everything that we're doing, Lord God. Get the glory and the honor out of our living, Lord God, out of our everyday life, Lord God. Because it's not enough just to come into the house of God and worship you, Lord God, with the saints. But, Lord God, it's another thing, Lord God, to worship you with our lives, Lord God. Lord God, allow us to live holy, live righteous, Lord God. Purify us, cleanse us, Lord God, with your Spirit. In the name of Jesus, oh God. Lord God, we need you, Lord God. We want you, Lord God. Lord God, we continue to pray, Lord God, over this father, this mother, this generation, Lord God. Lord God, we rebuke the generational curses, Lord God, even now in the name of Jesus, oh God, Lord God. And Lord God, we pray, Lord God, that they are more than conquerors, that they are victorious through Jesus Christ that loves them, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. And Lord God, we give you praise and we glorify you and we thank you, Lord God, for what you're doing, Lord God. For this is the day, Lord God, that you have made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Rejoicing that you have made a way for us over and over again. Rejoicing, Lord God, that you're providing a way for us, Lord God. Rejoicing and knowing, Lord God, that it's not by happenstance, Lord God. You did not create a mistake, Lord God, because you do not birth mistakes, Lord God. You was, Lord God, they were in the plan, Lord God, of you, Lord God, when their mama met their daddy, Lord God. And Lord God, I pray that you are rising up to become the great women and men of God that you have called them to be, Lord God, in the nation, oh God. Oh God, I just give you praise and I thank you, Lord God, that this nation will grow in hunger, Lord God. Lord God, we continue to pray, Lord God, for the saints of God. We continue to pray, Lord God, that you will turn your hand of judgment, Lord God, away from your people, Lord God, that your people will seek your face, that your people will turn away. That they will turn away from their wicked ways, Lord God, and that they will seek you, Lord God, and that they will humble themselves, oh God, and that you will hear from the mighty heavens above, and that you will heal their lands, their personal lands, Lord God. Lord God, we pray for greater glory, greater revival, Lord God, to sweep through the nation, Lord God, that you will send fire from heaven, Lord God. Lord God, we give you glory, Lord God, and we give you praise, Lord God, for what you are doing, God, in this season and in this time, oh God. We believe in your power, Lord God. Do miracles, signs, and wonders in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Set the captives free, Lord God, because your word said, Lord God, that whom the Son sets free is truly free indeed, oh God. So, Lord God, we pray, Lord God, freedom over your people, Lord God. Healing over your people, Lord God. Deliverance over your people, Lord God. Oh, God, I give you praise, Lord God, and we bless you, Lord God. Lord God, I pray for myself, Lord God, that if I've done anything wrong against you, Lord God, that you will forgive me, Lord God, that you will set me free, Lord God, that you will deliver me, Lord God. I pray over my leaders, Lord God, that you will heal them and deliver them and set them, Lord God, for anything that they may still be doing that is not your will, Lord God, and that we will stay humble at your feet, Lord God. I pray for my family now, Lord God, that you will deliver them and set them free, Lord God, from the bondages that they continue to hold on to and the generational curses, Lord God, and that they will turn away, Lord God, from drugs and alcohol, Lord God, and that they will seek you, God, and that they will live their lives every day to please you, oh God, in the name of Jesus, oh God. I pray over every auntie of mine, oh God, from grand aunties to now aunties, Lord God, that you will make a way for them, Lord God. Those that are, Lord God, independent, Lord God, don't really have help in their life, Lord God, comfort them, Lord God. Let them know, Lord God, that you have them protected, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, oh God. Oh God, just thank you, Lord God. Continue to pray, Lord God, for my BSF, Lord God, my best friend, Lord God, Chris Sadler, Lord God, that you will continue to provide a way for him, Lord God. Let him know that you love him, no matter how many times we may mess up, Lord God, to get up and to continue to suit up and do what you have called us to do, Lord God, because you're making us great. Slowly, 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 but you're making us great, God. Lord God, we just thank you. We just give you praise for what you're doing, Lord God. We pray for our enemies, God. That's something we don't do, Lord God, because it's something we don't want to do, to be honest with you, because we don't want to pray for those that did us wrong. But God, you told us in your word to pray, Lord God, for them, Lord God. So Lord God, we pray for our enemies. We see the love of God their way. We still love them despite what they did to us. And we pray for our enemies, Lord God, that they will prosper, Lord God, that they will find joy in loving you, that they will forgive, Lord God. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we love you. Lord God, we just give you glory, we just give you praise, and we honor you, we extol you. Lord God, we love you, Lord God. Lord God, we pray, Lord God, that you will be with us as we are going on this fast, Lord God. Lord God, we know that you're going to speak to us, Lord God. And we want to hear you, Lord God, and hear from you, Lord God. Lord God, allow us to have an ear to hear your voice. And allow us to have an eye to see your hand of mercy. Oh God, fill us, Lord God. Fill us with more of you, Lord God. Fill us with more of you, God. Fill us with more of you, God. Fill us with more of you, Lord God. We need more of you, Lord God, daily. In the name of Jesus, Lord God. Deliver our family members. Deliver us, Lord God. Deliver our church members, Lord God. Deliver our pastors, Lord God. Deliver the church, Lord God, nation, Lord God. Deliver, Lord God, the presidents, Lord God, former and present, Lord God. Deliver, Lord God, the government, Lord God. Deliver, Lord God, the police department. Deliver, Lord God, the state house, Lord God. Deliver, Lord God, the fire department, Lord God. Deliver this nation, Lord God. Deliver Africa, America, China, Jamaica, Lord God, Spain, Lord God, Cuba, Lord God, Atlanta, Lord God, Savannah, Lord God, Orlando, Lord God, deliver, Lord God, Washington, Lord God, deliver Baltimore, Lord God, Maryland, Lord God, deliver, Lord God, Kentucky, deliver, Lord God, Charleston and Myrtle Beach, Lord God, deliver Spartanburg, deliver, Lord God, Texas, Lord God, deliver, Lord God, Nebraska, Lord God, deliver Minnesota, Lord God, deliver, Lord God, deliver all of us, Lord God, deliver this nation as a whole, Lord God, deliver us, Lord God. Deliver us, God. Deliver us, God. Deliver us, Lord God. And Lord God, we just give you praise and we thank you for what you are doing, Lord God. We honor you, Lord God. Allow us to know, Lord God, when we come up against someone, Lord God, let us know, Lord God, if we're wrestling with flesh and blood or if we're wrestling against principalities and darkness, Lord God. Because I know your word says, Lord God, that we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but we wrestle against principalities and powers, Lord God. But there are some days, Lord God, when people are not operating under a demonic spirit, Lord God. So allow us to know, Lord God, so we'll know what to speak to and how to handle it, Lord God, and what to rebuke and cast down, Lord God. Lord, we just give you praise and we thank you, Lord God, for this day one of fasting, Lord God, that we're going to take it by storm. And God, we love you and we give you praise. And we give you praise, Lord God. Thank you for every intercessor, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. And just in your name, Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, shake, hallelujah. I don't know about you all, but the Spirit of the Lord is in this place. Oh, I just pray that you allow the Spirit of the Lord to dwell in your place. Because the Bible tells us that where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. And when two or three are gathered in his name, he is in the midst. Hallelujah. And God is here. I feel him in this place. And I believe that if he's here, he's in your place. So I just pray that you will embrace his presence today. Because there's nothing like his presence when you are. Let me tell you something about worship real quickly before I end this recording. When you are worshiping God, you begin to drift to a new dimension like never before. You begin to forget about the worries that you're going through, the trials and tribulations, because you know that there's nothing too hard, too big for God, and there are benefits with worship. Not only are you worshiping for yourself, but you're worshiping for others. Whoa, if I say. You're worshiping for your children. You're worshiping for your family members. You're worshiping for that troubled teenager, for that troubled niece or nephew of yours. You're worshiping for them. So always know that there are benefits to worship. Worship is awesome. It's communicating with the Father. And I don't want to seem all, you know, holy and dignified on you. But I love Jesus. You know, my prayer is to live holy and righteous, because we're supposed to, you know. So at the same time, I don't apologize. I don't want to seem like I'm better than anybody else, because I'm not. I'm a sinner too. But I love Jesus. And the good thing about it is you should be happy to be a sinner, because God died for sinners. So if you want to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you can do it by praying the sinner's prayer and accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and heart. I just pray that the baptism of the Holy Ghost will come upon you and you receive fire of the Holy Ghost. Amen. The Holy Spirit is a precious gift to have. It's here to help you. Amen. And we want to continue to pray for, of course, the churches that are being persecuted, because, you know, that's a part of the Antichrist. So we want to pray for that, that we won't be deceived by anybody that calls themselves a prophet. but they're really not. And they're just operating under the Antichrist spirit. We want to pray that we will be on board for that. I'm not really the type to get all excited about prophets and stuff like that. But, you know, just to know when there's a true one in your midst, and also to know when there's a false one. But we're not going to get into all of that. But I pray that you were blessed by this prayer this morning. God bless you all. Please share and like and subscribe to this YouTube channel. And this is day one of fasting. We have many more days, and we just thank God for having his way. And we're just praying that today's prayer was basically for deliverance. That God would have mercy on this nation, and this nation would turn away and see God's face, and that God would heal this land, heal our lands. So this was basically the prayer of deliverance. We was praying for deliverance and other things on today. Amen. Hallelujah and hallelujah. But God bless you all, and God loves you. So do I. Be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen.